He was a rebel and an outlaw and an outcast, but I never saw him do nobody harm. The rumor was he'd spent some time in prison. He told me he'd been working on a farm, but he always had us kids around for Christmas, and he'd always find a present for us all, and he'd always give us rides on the back of his Harley. Weren't for him there'd be no Christmas time at all. He had a Harley all in pieces in his kitchen, and bits of other bikes out in his yard, an eagle and a skull and crossbone tattooed on his arms, and a big tattoo of Santa on his heart. He was regarded pretty much as a loner, and we all wondered if he'd family of his own. But I don't remember seeing any photos at Christmas when he'd open up his home. He had this funny little pot plant in the corner that he'd dressed up just like a Christmas tree, and the laughter from us kids at the silly things he did, like them tiny bits of tinsel in his beard. He had a Harley all in pieces in his kitchen, and bits of other bikes out in his yard, an eagle and a skull and crossbone tattooed on his arms, and a big tattoo of Santa on his heart. Looking back, I often wonder where he'd be now, or even if he's still around at all, and if he still takes in kids. But wherever he is, it's 'cause of him I still believe in Santa Claus. And today I took my own kid to meet Santa, and after all these years he hasn't changed at all, except his hair's a little whiter and he's put on a bit more middle. Oh, but the laughter of them kids just said it all. Bet there's a Harley all in pieces in his kitchen, and bits of other bikes out in his yard, an eagle and a skull and crossbone tattooed on his arms, and a big tattoo of Santa on his heart. Bet there's a Harley all in pieces in his kitchen, and bits of other bikes out in his yard, an eagle and a skull and crossbone tattooed on his arms, and a big tattoo of Santa on his heart. Bet there's a big tattoo of Santa on his heart.
Oh, it's a lonesome away from your kindred and all, by the campfire at night, we'll hear the wild dingoes call. But there's a nothing so lonesome, morbid or drear, than to stand in the bar of a pub with no beer. Now the publican's anxious for the quota to come, and there's a far away look on the face of the bum. The mate's gone all cranky and the cook's acting queer. Oh, what a terrible place is a pub with no beer. Then the stockman rides up with his dry, dusty throat. He breasts up to the bar and pulls a wad from his coat. But the smile on his face quickly turns to a sneer as the barman says sadly, the pub's got no beer. Then the swaggy comes in, smothered in dust and flies. He throws down his roll and rubs the sweat from his eyes. But when he is told, he says, "What's this I hear? I've trudged 50 blaming miles to a pub with no beer." Now there's a dog on the veranda, for his master he waits. But the boss is inside, drinking wine with his mates. He hurries for cover, and he cringes in fear. It's no place for a dog, round a pub with no beer. And old Billy the blacksmith, the first time in his life, why, he's gone home cold sober to his darling wife. He walks in the kitchen, she says, "You're early, Bill dear." But then he breaks down and tells her the pub's got no beer. Oh, it's hard to believe that there's customers still, but the money's still tinkling in the old ancient till. The wine dots are happy, and I know they're sincere when they say they don't care if the pub's got no beer. So it's a lonesome away from your kindred and all, by the campfire at night, where the wild dingoes call. But there's a nothing so lonesome, morbid or drear, than to stand in the bar of that pub with a no beer.
Spend Christmas on the piss, yeah.
Drinking heaps of piss, drinking heaps of piss. Spent all fucking Christmas Day drinking heaps of piss.
I'm
dreaming out the shade, dreaming out the shade. Spent all fucking Christmas Day dreaming out the shade,
yeah.
Sweeping off the shit, sweeping off the shit. Spent all fucking Christmas Day sweeping off the shit
while we're
ringing out the shade. Ringing out the shade. Spent all fucking Christmas Day ringing out the shade.
Yeah,
Christmas on the piss, Christmas on the piss. Spent all fucking Christmas Day, Christmas on the piss. Christmas on the piss, Christmas on the piss. Spent all fucking Christmas Day, Christmas on the piss.
Yeah,
Christmas on the piss, Christmas on the piss. Spent all fucking Christmas Day, Christmas on the piss. Christmas on the piss, Christmas on the piss. Spent all fucking Christmas Day, Christmas on the piss. Spent all fucking Christmas Day, Christmas on the piss.
Quite often I get to thinking how as kids we got by. Like at Christmas time at our house, we couldn't even afford a fire. But we made do with what we had back then when I was young. Dad used to suck a peppermint and we'd all sit around his tongue. We couldn't afford no sparkly tinsel for our Christmas tree, so we'd just wheel old Grandad in and make the old cunt sneeze.
Wheel him round the other side, Nana.
But things changed pretty bloody quick. I got kids now of me own, and I heard them unwrap their prezzies last night when I got home.
Hey, Santa Claus, you cunt! Where's me fucking bike? I've unwrapped all this other junk and there's nothing that I like. I wrote your fucking letter and I come to see you twice. You want our geriatric fart, you forgot me fucking bike. If I'd have wanted a pair of bloody thongs, I would have bloody asked. And this cowboy suit and ping pong set you can shove right up your ass. You stuffed me bloody order up, it's enough to make you spew. But it's not just me who's snaky, me sister's dirty too.